Since I don't really show a lot of combat on this channel, I thought it would be a good idea to show it in this video. I'm not gonna lie, I've been having a lot of fun playing with ranged, partly because I'm kind of getting familiar with the abilities. I don't know, I wasn't really a fan of doing combat up until these last couple of days. Right now I'm at 57 Slayer, not sure how many levels I've gained since the previous video, and I'm at 55 ranged. I think I've gained about 3 levels here, which is pretty good, I like it. I needed 27 more lesser demons for this Slayer task. I think I'm getting a little bit addicted to combat. I'm not gonna lie. I was reading into what some of these abilities can do and how they can be combined together. You can do some pretty amazing things with them. Like if you use one of the two versions of Bind and then follow up with Piercing Shot, you get some extra damage. That's pretty cool. I put the Needle ability in the very front because if you hit with it, you also get bonus damage. Now, I don't know the name of the ability, so I'm just gonna point at them with the mouse. Here's how I've been starting every single fight with these lesser demons. Oh, there we go. We got a Slayer level. Cool. 58 Slayer. I've been starting off with this first one, then following up with Snipe, I think that's what this one is called. Then after Snipe, I go with the Threshold Bind, and the last one I use is Piercing Shot for that extra damage. That does a lot of freaking damage. It's pretty cool because I didn't know I could hit thousands back to back. I'm curious if you could do the same thing with all the other combat styles. I've yet to do it with melee and magic, but yeah, I'm doing Slayer because I really want to get to that higher level PBM content. I just want to be higher level overall. In terms of drops, these things don't really drop that many good items. Most of the stuff I've been picking up is black square shields, mithril weapons, and a bunch of fire runes because why not? One thing though, this bat is really freaking annoying. Okay, we need one more. Let's do it with the combo I've been talking about. We're gonna start with the needle one. We're gonna go with snipe. We're gonna go with bind. Boom, baby. Done. Okay, let's get out of here. Let's go get another task. Oh, I just remembered, we gained a Slayer level. Let's see what we could do. We can now kill cave horrors and unspeakable horrors. I don't even know where you could find those things. Okay, I've gained a decent amount of Slayer levels. I really want some more variety in these tasks. I've been getting the same things over and over again. I've been getting blood velts, basilisks, and that's pretty much it. It's just been a freaking rotation of those two. It's really annoying. Okay, Keldar, let's see what you're gonna give me. Please don't give me one of the two I just mentioned. Okay, we just did lesser demons. I don't know if I wanna keep doing that. We have a few Slayer tokens from the Halloween event. We're gonna go with Turoths because I've never killed Turoths before. We need to kill 154 Turoths. Okay, got any tips for me? The last Turoth I killed, I found stabbing attacks took them down effectively. Okay, looks like we're gonna go with melee. Turoths are large, vicious creatures with thick hides. You'll need a leaf-bladed weapon, broad arrows, or a magic dart to harm them. Seek them out in the Relic of Slayer caves. Okay, that's great because I just bought a leaf-bladed spear. I thought it looked cool, so that's why I got it. Not gonna lie, I've been wanting to use it, so this is perfect. Here is my amazing Slayer loot tab. Pretty impressive, right? Let's put all these new goodies into the tab. Oh, not my crossbows. I don't know what level Turoths are, so I'm just gonna take a bunch of tuna. I usually only leave my higher level foods for tougher monsters, but since I don't know what Turoths are, we're gonna go with tuna. Actually, I just remembered. I need to fix up the melee ability bar and the magic one, but melee is more important because I'm just about to use it. Okay, I fixed up my ability bar. I put abilities that I thought would be useful when used together, but I don't know. I'm gonna adjust it as I move on through these Slayer tasks. I've never really used melee in RuneScape 3, so I'm not familiar with a lot of the stuff in it. I don't know if that makes any sense, but I finished one whole trip of Turoths. Here's all the stuff I got. It's probably really dumb that I'm picking up all these seeds, but who knows, what if I need one of these items later? So it's better to be safe than sorry. We got about 3k Slayer XP from this task. We got one strength level. My strength level is really low, so I'm training it. We can now use the combat ability Cleave. I don't think I even have that slotted. I don't. Okay, let me go bank some stuff, come back here, and then finish it off. Or actually, before I move forward, let me see if I could price check this stuff. I'm not sure if the prices here are the Grand Exchange prices or if it's the High Alchemy prices. I'm just gonna assume it's the High Alchemy prices. This is about 26k, not including the herbs and the seeds because I'm gonna keep those and the gems as well. I don't know, 26k, that's not bad, I guess, for me because I'm not buying expensive items. All I really want the money for is for supplies like runes and arrows and whatnot, so okay, I guess it's good. Okay, let me go bank this stuff and come back with less food because surprisingly, they didn't even hit me. I just finished the next inventory of Turoths. It was very similar loot. I took a lot more of the lower level herbs. I'm not getting as many higher level herbs, so if I collect all the low ones, the XP will add up and that's what we all want. We want a lot of XP. I gained another strength level, by the way. We're almost at 50. And don't forget that combat stats are also in the 60 minimum, 70 maximum list. So we're getting closer to 60 with melee at least. It's not like we're not doing the list. We're 2 levels away from 60 Slayer. That's pretty cool. I would love to add this skill to the 60 minimum, 70 maximum ASAP. I like killing a lot of different monsters. I'm pretty sure everybody does. Okay, let me go bank this stuff and then finish off these 27 Turoths left. And then we can move on to another task. Okay, what are these two little beauties? Got a rune dagger. And we have an earth battle staff. Okay, that's cool. I have it so the beams light up whenever I get anything that's more than 3k. It is really useful because before that, I used to ignore a lot of things that were 3k, like a lot of the mithril and addy stuff. But now I pick it up, and then I get to alk it. Okay, we just got another 2 3k drops. How much is the rune dagger? 4.8k, and the addy plate legs, 3.8k. Okay, I'll take it. I'm a noob, so it justifies it. We're almost done with the task. 14 more Tarots, and I gained a prayer level too, so that's pretty cool. We can now do redemption. I've actually never really used prayer before. I gotta utilize it more often. I just find it difficult because you have to bring prayer pots. I don't have the resources to make that many prayer pots, so if I'm gonna use them, I wanna do something that's worth it. I guess I could use it to finish off this task, but I really see no point of it because I'm not struggling to kill these things. But screw it, we could do ultimate strength, increases your melee strength, and incredible reflexes, increases your melee attack rating. And we have another set of Addy Platelegs. Now, I don't know the best method to use prayers. Like, do you activate it only for the kill, and then deactivate it to save prayer points, or do you just keep it activated the whole time? I don't know. If there's some sort of efficient way of doing it, I would like to know. But to be fair though, I really don't see a difference in my hits. Actually, I don't even know if I hit 1.3k hits before. Maybe I just don't pay attention. I don't know, that's probably the case. Okay, there we go, we just finished the Slayer task. And we have two more loot beams. Let's take all the goodies and get another Slayer assignment. Whoops, I forgot my Draymond staff. Okay, I'm a big dummy because I was going over to the shed all the way around at the front of the castle through the cemetery when I could just go through the back. Totally forgot they opened this back part up. Okay, well that's nice to know. It's not like I'm gonna be with Keldar forever, but I guess it's useful for now. We're moving pretty good with combat. We're almost at 50 strength, like I said earlier. We're at 83 combat. We've come a long way in this Iron Man series. Okay, Keldar, what do you got for me? We could either kill 41 mutated Zygomites or 130 Harpy Bug Swarms. I'm not a fan of the Harpy Bug Swarms, so we're gonna go with the Zeramites, because I've never killed those either. Okay, do you have any tips for me? Mutated Zygomites are hard to destroy and attack with mainly magical damage. They regenerate quickly, so you'll need to finish them off with the fungicide. We have a bit of a problem with them here in Xanaris. Okay. I think she sells fungicide, I'm not entirely sure. Oh, by the way, I saw people with dual leaf-bladed swords. Where do you get those? I would love to have dual-wielding leaf-bladed swords. They looked freaking awesome. I'm not entirely sure what the difference between fungicide is and fungicide spray. I guess I'm just gonna take three of these. Or actually, I'm just gonna take one. Well, we do need 41 kills. I'm assuming each charge of this only counts towards one, so we're gonna take a few of them. I guess we'll find out how it works. Now, I wonder why she only gave me 41 of these things. Is it because they're pretty tough? If that's the case, I'm gonna take some lobsters just to see what they're all about. Now, where do I find them? They have to be here somewhere. I guess we're gonna explore Xanaris for a bit. I think I was here for some quest. Probably the fairy tale quest. I don't remember. This looks really familiar. Actually, I think it was the fairy tale quest because I think the cosmic altar is over here. I think this is the cosmic altar. I don't remember. It looks really cool though. These little mushroom caps are moving. I'm assuming these are the mutated zygomites. Let's see what happens if we try and pick one up. Mutated zygomites. Okay, that's cool. Level 65, they're not that bad. I don't think I'm gonna need all these lobsters, especially because I'm using the vampirism aura. Oh, that's right. We gotta finish them off. Did it use one charge? It did. Okay. Good thing I bought all four of them then. I'm not gonna take those stupid seeds. Wait, can I spray them beforehand and then they'll die right away once I finish them off? Nope, okay. That's pretty cool. I've never used... Hey, we just got 50 strength. That's cool. We could do something. What is it? Level 50 strength is one of the requirements for the Legends quest. I can now do barbarian swordfish catching, and I could use the Zephyrium Maul and Daemonheim. Okay, killing these things is a little bit of a hassle. Good thing we only have 41 of them. Okay, I'm gonna finish this task, and then we might move on to one more. Two more of these mutated zygomites left. Their drops are not very good. I just took the low level seeds because I could use them in player owned farms. I literally haven't been there in a while. My rabbits are probably dead. I really should go back there. Oh, I am out of fungal spray. If I use this fungicide I got as a drop on the spray, will it refill it? It does. Okay, that's perfect. There we go. We finished the zygomite task. I almost forgot what they were called. Okay, let's go get one more because I'm having a lot of fun doing this. I really didn't realize how fun PBM was. It takes you all over RuneScape to kill monsters. I like it. Okay, we can do 109 grotworms or we can do 40 bronze dragons. Which one gives me the best XP? I know grotworms is used for ranged and bronze dragons, I think they're weak to magic. I don't know where I could find bronze dragons though. I would like to do magic, I'm not gonna lie. I don't know, this is a toughie. I think you can actually get some dragon weapons or armor from bronze dragons, and grotworms gives you tons of rune drops. Which one's better for me? I would say getting dragon drops, because where else am I gonna get dragon armor? Shops don't sell it. Okay, I just checked the RuneScape wiki. Apparently bronze dragons have a rare drop of dragon plate legs. We're gonna go with the bronze dragons. What if we get lucky and get dragon plate legs? I could really use those, so what are the tips for me, Keldar? The last bronze dragon I killed, I found water spells took them down effectively. Okay, looks like we're gonna go and use water spells. Bronze dragons are the weakest of the metallic dragons, but their bronze scales are far thicker than normal bronze armor. They lay wait for you in the Brimhaven dungeon and chaos tunnels. You'll be well served by taking a defense against their breath. Let's get our anti-dragon shield, our runes, and our armor, and head over to Brimhaven. Okay, we are here. These guys are level 98, and these are level 100. I definitely don't want to mess with these two. That's a dragon egg. That's pretty dope. There's a dungeon here. Can I go in it? I need 80 dungeoneering for that one. Okay. It's probably filled with more of these dragon types. Where are the bronze ones though? I'm really glad that these things are not hostile, because I would have been screwed. It would have been fun though, having a bunch of dragons try and kill you. Where are the bronze ones? This guy looks cool. I want a shield like that. How do I get that shield? I think that's the greater version of this one. I think if you attach a visage or visage, whatever you call it, to this one, it turns into that one. I really want one. I'm gonna go look over here. Oh, here are the bronze dragons. Okay, are these hostile? Oh, I think this one is hostile. That guy's about to die. Yeah, he's dead. He's gonna die for sure. Okay, that's not cool at all. Why would you not eat? Can I bless his gravestone? Nope, I cannot. Okay. Well, if this guy attacks me, I am screwed. I'm gonna stay away from him. I think he can't attack me if I'm standing across this barrier. Okay, I guess we can start attacking this thing. Okay, this isn't too bad. They're not hitting me that much. We only need to kill 40 of these, so we should be fine. Maybe in two inventories of bronze dragons, we'll be able to leave. Just got another achievement. Can opener. Okay, that's a lot of bronze bars. I'm not gonna take any of those because I'm not a noob. I am gonna take these law runes though. And the dragon bones. Cross your fingers that I get a dragon plate like drop. I am just about to finish this bronze dragon task. This is my second trip here. I've been collecting all the bones because at some point I'm going to use these on a gilded altar for a lot of prayer XP, which is going to be great. I gained one constitution level. That's good. 27k left for the next magic level and 10k left for 59 slayer. Not bad. Now there's six dragons left. Unfortunately, I didn't get any dragon plate like drop, but I mean, that's okay. I could always come back here and just camp this spot until I get one. For now, let me go bank the stuff. Come back and finish this task. We need one more dragon, people. Just one more. There we go. We completed I don't know how many Slayer tasks. 23 tasks in a row. That's good. And we didn't get a single dragon plate like drop. Let's go get another task, and then I'll end the video there. Let us see what she's gonna give us. We could either do 168 Infernal Mages, which is okay, and 149 Kalphites. Infernal Mages, I think, are weak to ranged, and Kalphites are weak to magic, so I might go with Kalphites, but I'm not sure. I guess I'll do Infernal Mages just because I could also do a contract for it and get some money. Okay, I guess we're gonna do Infernal Mages then. Okay, that's gonna be it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. I'll see you all in the next video. Peace.